Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, we had a good discussion on weighted codes and its types and one of the type of the non-weighted code, that is access-3 code. In today's class, we will having a discussion on gray codes and the alphanumeric codes. This slide explains the properties of the gray code and how can we extract the gray code from the binary input. In order to understand this, just look upon these properties of the gray code, that it is a non-weighted code, it is a BCD code, it is also called unidistance code and the reflective code. These are the another name of the gray code. In order to understand the gray code, we have to recall the truth table of the XOR gate, that is 00, 01, 10, and 11. XOR gate says that if the inputs are same, then output is 0. If the inputs are alternate, then output is 1. So this is basically XOR gate. XOR gate plays an important role in the conversion of the binary to the gray code. If you see this example, we are having the data 11101. This is binary data because the base is 2. As it shows, it is the binary data. Moreover, it is in the form of 0 and 1 only. Now see, just write the data 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Simply like the input 1. The funda to convert this binary into gray is just to write this first bit. This first bit as it is and XOR it with the next bit. This symbol is of the XOR. The first step is just copy the first bit, fine, and then XOR it with the next bit. 1 and 1 is known as 0, so that's why I mentioned 0 over here. 1 and 1 is again 0, so I mentioned 0 here. 1 and 0 is 1, I mentioned 1 here. 0 and 1 is 1, I mentioned 1 here. So overall, if we see the XOR truth table plays an important role, we can have a good example like this also. So write the first bit as it is. 1 and 0 is, see the truth table, 1 and 0 gives us a 1. So write 1. 0 and 1 gives a, again 1, write 1. 1 and 0 again, triple. Okay, so this is the process that how we can convert a binary to the gray. Just we have to recall the XOR truth table, nothing else. So next is the ASCII code. The thing which you have to keep in mind in order to understand the ASCII code is the acronym of the ASCII, that is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Sometimes the examiner can ask this question that what is the full form of ASCII. Fine. It represents number, letters, punctuation, marks, and many more. The thing which you have to keep in mind is it is a 7-bit code. If it is a 7-bit code, 2 raised to the power 7 is 128. So it forms a 128 characters. Another type of the ASCII code is the extended ASCII code. That is the 8-bit. If it is the 8-bit 2 raised to the power 8, which means it forms a 256 characters. Most of the time it includes the graphics only. Fine. So extended ASCII adds the graphics and the math symbol to code total 256 symbols. So this is the main difference between the extended and the simple ASCII. Simple ASCII is of 7-bit and extended ASCII is of 8-bit. What exactly lies in 8-bit is the graphics and the math symbols. So this is the chart through which you can memorize the representation of the ASCII code. Here it shows that A is having a ASCII code of the 65, which you have to keep in mind. Fine. I'll tell you that how the examiner can ask the question, but yes, A ASCII code is 65. Fine. Excuse me. Now, if an examiner asks that write the ASCII code for the CAT, then ASCII code for CAT is 67, 65 and 84. Fine. Now, further you can represent it in the form of the codes. You can just convert this decimal into the binary by dividing, and you can represent it in this form. This is CA and this is for the C and this is for the T. How it comes, we can have a look on one of the, for example, if I am taking the 67, just divide it by the 2 because we are just calculating the binary, so I am dividing it with the 2 only. So write 33, one remainder, 16, one remainder, 2 8 the 16, 0 remainder, 2 4 the 8, 0 remainder, 2 2 the 4, 0 remainder, and 0 remainder. Write from the down to top, 1 double 0 double 0 double 1. So write or see here, 1 double 0 double 0 double 1. In order to make it of the 8 bits, we are adding 0 here. We are just 0 padding here because it is of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In order to make it 8 bit, we are just adding 0 in the front. So this is the way that how we can convert this decimal into the binary. Same happens with the 65 and the 84. So this is the way that we can represent any ASCII code in the binary form. Thank you.